This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I'm going to show how to find the growth time for an investment. So here's our problem. It says, how long will it take for an investment of $1,500 to grow to $2,500 if it is A, compounded quarterly at 8%, and B, compounded continuously at 8%? Okay, so we'll start out with the compounded quarterly part of this. We've got a formula for compounded interest. That's A equals P times 1 plus R over N raised to the NT power. So let's take that formula and fill in whatever numbers we can from the problem. A is the amount of money we're going to end up with, and we want to end up with $2,500. So we'll have $2,500, 2,500 equals P. P is the principal, the amount you invest. So that's $1,500. We're going to multiply that by 1 plus R. So R is 8%, that's the rate. We'll write that as a decimal point, 0.08, divided by N, which is the number of compounding periods each year. This is compounded quarterly. So n would equal 4. And then we're raising that to the nt power. N, once again, is 4, the number of compounding periods, and t is what we're looking for. Okay, so now we're down to just one variable, the t, so we should be able to solve this. The first thing I'll do is divide both sides of the equation by 1,500. So on the left, I've now got 2,500 over 1,500. Let's reduce that fraction. I'll divide the numerator and the denominator by 100, and then I have 25 over 15. I can divide both of those numbers by 5. So I'll get 5 over 3 equals, I've got this 1 plus 0.08 divided by 4. Well, let's see, 8 divided by 4 is 2, so 0.08 divided by 4 would be 0.02, and we're raising that to the 4t power. So let's clean this up a little more. I have 5/3 equals 1.02 raised to the 4t power. So the t is an exponent. When we're looking for an exponent in a problem like this, we want to take the logs of both sides of the equation. So I'm going to have the log of 5/3 equals the log of 1.02 to the 4t. And then using the rule that says I can take the exponent and make it into the coefficient of a logarithm, I'm going to get the log of 5/3 equals 4t times the log of 1.02. Now I just want to divide both sides by the log of 1.02. So I have the log of 5/3 over the log of 1.02. That equals 4t. And then I would just divide the left side, divide both sides of the equation by 4. So I've got the log of 5/3 over the log of 1.02. That whole thing divided by 4. And that's going to equal t, or the time it's going to take for this to grow to the $2,500 we want. Okay, at this point we use a calculator. So we'll find out what the log of 5/3 is. After we've got that, we want to divide it by the log of 1.02. And when we've got that, we'll divide that answer by 4. And we end up with 6.448. And that equals t. I'm going to round this to 2 decimal places. So I'm going to get the time is 6.45 years. Okay, so that's when it's compounded quarterly. Let's take a look at the other part of the problem and see what happens when it's compounded continuously. Okay, so when it's compounded continuously, we use a different formula. That one is A equals P times E raised to the RT. So A, once again, is the amount we end up with, and we end up with $2,500. P is the principal, that was $1,500. And then we're multiplying that by E to the rate. We have the rate, that's 8% or 0.08 T. T is what we're looking for. Okay, so we just want to solve this problem now. I'll divide both sides by 1,500. And then I'll reduce this fraction, 2,500 over 1,500. That's the same fraction I had before. So that's 5/3 equals E to the 0.08 T. I'll take the natural log of both sides. So that's going to be ln of 5/3 equals ln, the natural log of E to the 0.08 T. Then I'll take that exponent and make it into a coefficient. So the natural log of 5/3 will equal 0.08 T times the natural log of E. But the natural log of E is 1, so we'll just cross that out. And now to get the T by itself, I just divide both sides by 0.08. So the natural log of 5/3 divided by 0.08 will be equal to the time. On the calculator, I'm going to find the natural log of 5 divided by 3. And once I've got that, I'll divide that by 0.08. And I'm going to get 6.385. That number keeps going. And that equals time. I'll simplify this down. I'll round this down to two decimal places also. So that's going to be, I'll make that 6.39 years. So remember, the first time around when it was compounded quarterly, we had 6.45 years. Compounded continuously, it'll take a little less time, 6.39 years. Okay, that's about it. Take care. I'll see you next time.